What's happening, everybody? This is Lightning Bolt Forever, back again with a new game this time. And sorry this is taking so long. I meant to, you know, have this up by, like, you know, just a couple days after my 1 year anniversary status update thing, but needless to say, my internet has not been very nice to me, so yeah, I was waiting until I got a good enough signal internet strength before I did this. So anyway, here we go. This game is called Drop, and this has got to be, like, one of the best puzzle games I think I've ever played. This one, it kinda is like Tetris, only, it's a little bit more complicated than just Tetris. This game comes in three modes: Infinite Mode, Challenge Mode, and Hyper Mode. And over here you can see sort of like a tiny little description of each. Who is this game made by? iSurf Inc. 2002, that's old. You can't stop the drop. But anyway, it was distributed by eGames, and I don't even know where you can find this game anymore. Like, I don't even think this game is in any stores. But anyway, if you want to read more about these modes, you can just, if you have this game, because I don't know many people that do, but if you have this game, then you can just read more, and, hang on. Sorry about that, had to cough. Anyway, we're just gonna go ahead. I don't know how much of this game I'm going to play, but, switch frame moves, okay. Yeah, there's not a whole lot of settings in this game, so if there's any cropping issues, there's not a whole lot I can do about it, because this game, it only lets me record in 800x600. Pretty crappy, I know, but oh well. It's time to get started with this. We're gonna go with Hyper Mode, because it is my favorite mode, and it's just fast and relentless, so let's go. How to play. Use the mouse or arrow keys to move the switcher. Line up three or more drops in a row or column to score points. You switch drops by pressing the shift key or with a mouse click. Line up four or more drops in a row or column to clear the hyper drop chamber on the left and to score points. If any drops reach the top of the game area, the game is over. Quick tip, crystal drops are good. Stone and chrome drops are bad. You should keep crystal drops in the game. Yeah, I could have just clicked don't show this tip again, but, I just wanted to show you guys, just briefly explain how all that stuff works. But anyway, yeah, that's the whole premise of this game, is to switch marbles around and dissolve them. That is the whole game. Now, the reason I say this is like Tetris, it actually does have a very interesting puzzle mode, and that's what Challenge Mode is all about. That mode, you're solving, like, a bunch of different, like, you go through, like a ton of different stages, and just, like, you have to use your brain to, you know, solve these puzzles. It's very interesting, and, maybe I'll show off a little bit of that. But anyway, what you just saw there, and as you can see over to the left here, is the crystal drop. Crystal drops will dissolve any kind of drop that they touch. So, yeah, it just hit the red drop, so all the red drops have been cleared off the board. Chrome drops, or the white ones here, you can move them, but if you try to line them up like, you know, regular drops, they don't do anything. Now, the worst ones are these stone ones right here, right under here. You cannot move these. They don't move, and they're just a pain in the butt, because they can keep you from getting quite a considerable amount of points if you're trying to line up, you know, drops in a row. So that's one of the ways that is more of a, well, it's a complete hindrance instead of just more or not, I don't know. But anyway, yeah, I could have done the tutorial on, like, how this game works, but honestly, it's way too simple. It's a puzzle game. It's like Tetris. It's simple enough, but, you know, it's not that hard. I'm probably just gonna play this until maybe, I guess, when I reach the top, or, you know, when a certain amount of time has been up. And by that, I mean I'm trying to keep track of my time, because I don't want this video to be too long. I definitely am going to do more of this game. I'm actually going to do the challenge mode and let you guys see just how, sweet, stone drops are gone. Let you guys see just how, like, how little I think about these things, or, yeah. Get rid of the orange ones, thank you. Music is catchy, though. And yeah, the reason those flashed, even though it was a 3 combo, is because, it was like a chain reaction. But anyway, yeah, the music, it is catchy, but I'll admit, it does get a little old after a while. I don't know. And you think for a game made in 2002, they would have, you know, maybe come up with like a better, I don't know, like different, not a better music track, because it really is cool, but I mean like a different, like different music tracks. Or whatever. I don't know. Doesn't matter. Oh, crap. Alrighty. Well, I guess there was nothing we could do about that. Yeah, you can't control where these things fall, so they just pick a place and they... Crap, I could not move that one out of the way. Anyway. Oh, yeah. Yeah, see? 3 chrome drops don't dissolve, so yeah. And here comes some more stones. Give me the stones, Dr. Jones. Sorry about that. Okay, anyway, let's just... Why did I do that? Okay. Yeah, I'm probably going to be thinking out loud a lot in this recording, but anyway, yeah. We just gonna keep on doing this. Yeah, and this pretty much never ends until there's a column that reaches the top of the thingamabobber, or wherever, yeah, the top of the game area, so... Yeah, whatever. Don't matter. Anyway, I keep saying that a lot. I don't know why. Maybe I just have nothing to say. I don't know. What am I talking about? Okay. Yeah. I gotta like get a moment to think here. Let's make a combo 4. There we go. And of course, as you would normally expect, you get more points for the number of combos, so yeah. If, yeah, you can get, 3-point combos, 4-point combos, 5-point combos, hell, even 6-point combos, but those are very, very rare. But, there is one level in challenge mode where you can actually get a 6-point combo. And it's very cool looking. I will say that much, it's very cool looking. And I have no red drop to fill in that one, so yeah. Yeah, see, stones do not move. Hate those frickin' stones. Alrighty. Drop this one. Oh, crap. That one fell in between the gap there, or the drops, or wherever. And the game board is filling up, and I am probably about to get a game over here, so... Maybe. I don't know. Maybe not. I need another orange. There you are. Okay. There we go. Ah, green. Oh, well, I guess that's the end of this, then. Oh, let's see what time. Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and end this here. So, yeah, this was just a quick little brief playthrough of this really awesome puzzle game called Drop by iSurf. And, yeah, I guess I'll do more of this game, but, yeah, I suppose... I guess the next thing I'll post up will be another episode of Battlefront 2, so until then, this is Lightning Bolt Forever, and I will see you good people later. Bye-bye.